if you maybe already know. I find most humans very abhorrent. I mean, very abhorrent to me. Being lazy, they're being arrogant, they're being so selfish. They believe that the whole world belongs to them, and that they're being the most intelligent species on this whole planet. Maybe I have a little bit too high standards. Maybe. But I have my standards. And if that makes me arrogant, I don't care. I stand for something. I stand for justice. No matter if it been popular or it been political correct, I will always be for the victims of any atrocity. I will fight for what being right. If I see evil, I don't can deny it. When I see injustice with my own eyes, I will oppose it. No matter if it be not popular to do, no matter if anybody is against it. That I do it. I do it. Because I mean justice. Because I stand for something. Because I be rather true to myself and encourage the radicals of others than be false and encourage my own abhorrence. Because I be not a puppet. Because I do not blindly what me being told, because I be afraid for punishment. How will you fight to one person that have nothing to lose? How will you fight against somebody that won't give about if he been murdered or killed? How do you fight against somebody that don't sacred his own life? Is fighting against somebody that's a suicide bomber. You don't can win. That's the mindset that you need to if you want to change this world for the better way. The world, so it be now, be controlled by capitalists, countries. Countries that have one only standard. You can call it fascism, you can call it vandalism, you can call it no matter how you want it, but it's still being the system of commodification, discrimination, and enslavement. It's the same system of slavery. Might make rights. The majority want it. Evil people been always in the majority. Around whole history, there's always a small group of people. A small group that have to convince the majority why something is right, if something is wrong. There's always a small groups of white privileged slave masters that have to stand up against the majority of all the slave masters before that the slaves even get a chance to fight for themselves. There's always a small majority group of white men that have to come up for the rights of women before all the women can have even a little vote, a little decision. And before that becomes serious in the eyes of the oppressors. So why so much humans become irritating? This is so blasphemous to me. If they're being accused of something unjust, if around whole history, the majority is not on the right side of justice, and the majority of people do just what the status quo wants them to do. They don't want to change. They want to have their cake. They don't want to give something back what in the first place not belongs to them. What give the slave masters in the first seconds of the decision, the right to take the rights of blacks away? Historically, the positions of sexism and heterosexism and racism being there by challenging the superiority of the intelligence of women and blacks and gay people. If you look to the historic of this, of forms of oppression, and the superiority or superiority of the, and increasing the superiority of the slave master, the oppressor, the tormentor. But what have in the first place give them the right to do that? And it's the same thing with animals. Yes, some animals be less smart than some humans. But statistics can also be misused. And that is also something that the white supremacists do. And by the way, the intelligence test being something maketh by humans, the oppressors, something so funny as well. My observation of that so-called intelligence of humans, I come to the conclusion that it being actually manipulation. What are that mean? Manipulation of words, manipulation of language, manipulation of concepts, theories that were profound as truths. There been actually not a lot of things that you can say they've been true what humans have found. The most of the things that humans claim been actually only concepts. Not truths. Most likely one of the only things that been absolute is global warming. I think that is a pretty decent argument. Because look to the whole world becomes warmer and warmer. Not in some places. That's the reason that you maybe can call it climate change in the extent of global warming. Because some places it become warmer and other places it become colder. But in the majority of it, in the bigger picture, anything become warmer. And the seas become more acidic. Well, in the time of the ice ages, not the last ice ages, but the one that the dinosaurs been ready with. Any second we destroy one, any day we destroy one part of rainforest with the size, with the big, I mean bigger than the size of New York City. Around something like 230,000 acres of rainforest. We cut any day for a hamburger, for an addiction of greed and murder. the most biggest Holocaust ever existed. And for the people there and they say, it is insulting to call it a Holocaust. Let me explain for you the real ends. First, most important definition of an Holocaust. Holocaust in Hebrew means the sacrifice of a male animal on the altar of God. So, ironic that it can be used to mean the sacrifice of a human or the murder of a human, but not by for the originally designed victims. So funny how victimizers always use manipulation and deceit to trick anybody in accepting the abuse. And also one, this one US philosopher, Isaac Bashevis Singer, he say actually in his words, What are now all the leaders of the world, all the philosophers, they have convinced themselves that man, the worst transgressor of all the species, is the crown of creation, and all other animals be nearly to provide him with food, with clothing and entertainment. In relation to them, all men, all humanity, be Nazis. For the animals, it is an eternal Treblinka. This man have escaped Nazi-occupied Poland. So, awaken humanity. And understand that the way we be treated the other animals is indirectly the same essence of hatred that humans use to discriminate between other animals. Speciesism. This is the first form of hatred that people been taught long before heterosexism, long before anti-Islamism, long before any form of discrimination. Speciesism is the first form of hatred. If you, a person grow up and he's been told that that chicken is different than you, but he's different, that don't mean that you have to treat him unfairly. If the child grow up and see one pig and you told him, the pig looks different than you, but this pig deserves the same rights of living and liberty as you. If that child grow up and look to a pig and a cow and you say, this cow is different than you, but he have the same right to live as you have. If that child grow up and then see one person, human, with another color of hair or a color of skin, and he look to the other person, how can a person then go up and say, I think that he is superior, that he is more important? It all have something in common. If you go to the essence of discrimination, it always go that some group on arbitrary criteria think that are being better than others. Nazis believe that they're being better because they've been told it, and they think that people with blonde hair and pale skin and blue eyes being better, and because the Jewish population was richer in general than the other groups, and therefore or the victim blame the Nazis, the Jews for their mistakes of the Nazis, for the mistake of the Germans or Nazis, or how you want to call them. In my opinion, the Nazis that believed the absurdity of Adolf Hitler, that were the Nazis, and the people that be not fighting for Hitler and his white supremacist philosophy, there was Germans. If you want to know the truth about that. For somebody say that not all Nazis being evil. Yes, all Nazis been evil. But not all Germans were Nazis. Hitler purifies, actually. The same thing that he say, we don't murder cows and pigs, we slaughter them. Just like the Nazis say, we don't murder Jews in the concentration camps, we euthanize them. They're always use victimizers use always euphemisms. Always. And those people being too lame, or too stupid, or too arrogant, or whichever, want to find out the truth. And that's one of the most biggest errors or sins, or how you want to call it, of the humans. Nobody want to find out the truth. They all want to live in fantasy land where anything is perfect and holy. And that they don't have to stand up for their mistakes, and that they have to do something about it. The apathy is so a blessing. For somebody that have opened his eyes and have seen the truth. For somebody that have seen the truth with his both eyes. You cannot close anymore. You have to speak up. You have to speak out. You have to oppose it. Even this one quote of that's one very wise quote of Martin Luther King. Such haste means the temperature. There is something so dear, something so precious, something so internally true, that it's been worth dying for. And I submit that if you have not find something, are you willing to die? I say you. This person is not fit for life. Power will not come without one command. Another will be, and another shall be, and another have be. Those who prefer freedom and this it's agitation. Being men, how well crops without ploughing the acres, and men how wants to have rain without thunder and lightning. Power will nothing come without a command. It will nothing will be and nothing shall be. What I want to say, that there have to come a great revolution, a great awakening in the whole world. If we want to save this planet from human arrogance and human follies and human flaws and human psychosis. You don't be good because you've been human. You don't be perfect just the way you've been. But when you become vegan, you do actually something to reduce the injustice, the evil and the violence that we do on this planet. It is all hard enough for the animals to live with us. Have you on top of that also to murder them and eat them? We murder any year as whole humanity around something like 150 billion innocent animals in fish farms and in concentration camps that we so euphemistically refer as slaughterhouses. Most of these animals we artificial inseminate, which so actually been a euphemism for rape. They take a bare hand, put it in the vagina of the cows, and put bull semen in it. That's rape. Rape is forcefully insemination. So, awaken humanity. Animals be not on this planet for humans, for clothing, entertainment, or anything like that. Just like women be not on this planet for punching bags and sex toys for their boyfriends and husbands. Just like blacks be not on the planet for the service of the white man. Just like animals being also not on this planet for the service of the white man or the black man or the woman, human. They're being on this planet alone for themselves. They're being not objects. They're being not stupid toys. This kind of irrational and stupidity being absolutely outdated and totally 100% insane. Animals being sentient, aware creatures, and if you then think animals be not sentient and aware, you've been crazy or something like that. If they're not being sentient and aware, how can they survive in the wilderness? How can they locate water to drink if they are being thirsty? How can they locate foods? How can they hide when they not want to be seen? How can there? Why there fly in a V formation? If they're not want to be attacked by predators. In Cudney, why beavers? If they're not sentient and aware, take seaweed around their hands and their tail. If they don't want to drive away with the water flow. It's so insane always. We do this over and over again. Can we not go to the table and say any living being deserves their ego rights and their freedoms? To be not tormented, to not be turned in an inanimate object. Why do we have always to go to the table of justice to make something illegal so that the majority don't do it anymore? The majority of robots Fine that you have hurt my ramp. If you've been still here and not me click away because you've been too much offensive. And I hope that you respect my honesty. Because a lot of people don't do. Because their ego is so maniacal, so extremely big, that they don't seem to get the reality that humans be not so special. And that we be an endemic species. So go vegan and help to stop extreme amounts of injustice and cruelty and injustice. You can save a lot of water, you can save any day, any time that you have eat. No meat. You can save any day around something like if you live in America, 1 pound of meat costs to produce something like 2,500 gallons of water, around something like 80 cube of CO2, and around something like 18 pound of greens, and around something like 5.5 feet of rainforest. They've been destroyed only for a steak and hamburger, or something like apathetic like that. We can also feed the whole world. That's very easy. You only have to a sense of logic. Think about it.